What's up guys, welcome back to yet another interesting video on the features of the Redmi 9 Power. Now I have been making videos, like series of features videos on this Redmi 9 Power, so make sure you watch the entire video, and there are some other videos related to this one as well. So if you just follow my channel, you will be able to watch all those videos. So in today's videos, like continuing with the features, let's look at some of the tips and tricks, or rather features, about the Redmi 9 Power. Now if you have got the MIUI 12 version on your Redmi phones, you can just apply these features and utilize it to the fullest, right? So guys, looking at the first feature in this video, before we begin this video, like if you are new to my channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button. Also like and share this video if you find it interesting or rather helpful. Now looking at the features, the first one is within the settings. Obviously we have to go to settings, and here you will find additional settings. So here's the additional setting, and you have the accessibility. If you just tap on this one, you'll find like a lot of tabs over here. This is general, vision, hearing and physical. So just tap on physical button, and here you'll find this feature called power button ends the call. Now what this basically does is, like if you are talking on phone and instantly want to disconnect the phone without having to like swipe up or use any gestures, just use this, switch on this feature. By default it will be turned on, so just go ahead and turn this on. Now what happens is, like while you are attending any call, and if you quickly want to disconnect, you just tap on, or rather press, the power button, so it automatically disconnects the call. So that's kind of nice thing, like shortcut you can use. So that's the first feature. The second feature is inside again settings. This is one-handed mode, like you might be aware of this one because it's really a convenience feature, we say. So if you just tap on this one-handed mode, there are like three options. One is 4.5 inches, 4.0 inches, and there is 3.5 inches, right? So by default, this will be turned on. Now, depending on your convenience, again, if you just turn this on, and I have actually set to 4 inches, which means if I just swipe left like this, the screen will go to one-handed mode. As you will see right now, as you can see, the entire mobile screen is within 4 inches, within reach of single hand. So you can, like if you are working on with the other hand, you can just use this hand to like operate the mobile. So again, a convenience feature. If you want to quickly return back to normal, just again swipe left like this, it returns to normal. Similarly, if you are a right-handed person, just swipe right like this. Again, from back, if you just swipe back, so it will return to normal. Again, a convenience feature you can utilize whenever it's needed. So that's again a second feature. The third one is again here, which is quick ball. So this is a nice feature. As you can see, there are so many things that you can customize or rather change. Again, there is actually a small like semicircle over here. If you find this mark, if you just tap on this one, there are a whole bunch of shortcuts you can use. Again, this is very customizable. That's what makes this MIUI 12 very interesting. Again, if I just tap on this one quickly, I can access the calculator or any app that you have set. So to set that, just tap on this select shortcuts. So if you go to select shortcuts, you'll find all these shortcuts. There are 5 shortcuts you can actually customize. Again, if I just tap on this calculator, like if you want to quickly turn on the Bluetooth, instead of swiping down going to the notification, you can just bring this icon over here. Just tap on this one, you'll find the Bluetooth option over here. If I just set this one, right? So if I tap on this one, you'll find the Bluetooth icon. Similarly, you can change to all these things. Like I have set the second one to torch, right? So if I just tap on this one, torch, instantly the torch is turned on. So this is how quickly you can select shortcuts, again using the quick ball function. Similarly, you can make it show on the lock screen as well, so that you don't have to go to the home screen to change it every single time. Like right, we are on the home screen, or rather lock screen. Just swipe this one and use this feature to turn the torch on quickly, or do whatever you want. So again, that can be customized or set here in the select shortcuts. Again, there is a preferred gesture, like how you want to bring that quick ball icon, right? So there is swipe feature. If I just go ahead and swipe like this, I can quickly go and touch on that. Similarly, I can take screenshot like this instantly. There you go. So that's how the preferred gesture works. Again, a convenience feature, depending on your preference, you can set those things. So that's again a quick third feature. The fourth one is with the button shortcuts here. So button shortcuts, again, it's written button. So the physical buttons, or rather these home as well as recent as well as back button, can be customized according to preference. Let's say if I just tap and hold this home button, so what function it should access, right? So let's say I go to turn on torch. Again, I set it to like long press the home button. So if I press and hold the home button for a long period, the torch is turned on. So again, depending on your preference, you can customize these things. Let's say how you turn off the screen, long press the back button, I have said. So if I just tap and hold the back button, you can just turn the screen off. You don't have to like press this button to lock the screen. Again, a shortcut feature here. The fifth feature is the full screen display. Depending on what apps you are using, you can change the full screen display. Again, there is full screen gestures here. Instead of using these buttons, this can be utilized to the like full screen display itself. And there is this learn feature. You can actually tap on this and it will tell you like how you can use the gestures, right? So swiping up like this will go to home screen. Again, swiping up and holding will go to recent screen like this. Again, if I just swipe right like this, back screen. Again, from the right, if I just swipe left like this, it will go to forward screen. So that's how the gestures works. It's again a very simple thing that you can get used to. So again, you have to like have some practice over there. So as you can see, the screen is fully utilized now. So if I just press on button again, it's normal. Again, you can mirror these buttons. So if I just off this one, as you can see, here's the back button, home screen, as well as recent. If I want to mirror that one again, I can change that. So again, depending on your convenience, you can change this. There is this new control center here, like I showed in my earlier videos. So if you just tap on this one, you'll control center. If I swipe down like this, this is the new control center of the MIUI 12 version, as you can see. A sort of iPhone-ish look, I would say. So you can turn that off as well. Again, there is a lot of customization things like tips and tricks you can utilize. So I'll be making series of videos. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click on that like button and do share it with your friends. All right, guys, that's it in this video. I'll see you all in another one. Till then, take care, everyone. Bye-bye.